I just read your second Players Tribune article, which, by the way, I just, for a second, leave it to Derek Jeter, who, after being the king of New York for almost 20 years, his first off-the-field endeavor is something that sports journalism has been needing for years. But your articles, both of them, have been fascinating. In your newest article entitled Jermaine, you talk about what-ifs. And how often do you play the what-if game?
I'm glad you asked me that. You know, the what-if game, people ask me that all the time. Like, well, you know, how do you not say the what-ifs? Like, well, what if you could have been in the NFL? What if you could have been winning the Super Bowl? You know, what if this or what if that? And, you know, I don't play too much. Of course, every day it creeps into your mind, like, what if this, what if that, especially when things get tough. But I always come back to the great things that I'm doing right now. And, you know, the people that I have in my life, you know, how can I, what if all those, all the things that are going on right now, like being able to write a book or being able to do those articles with the Players Tribune, being able to do the therapy, travel all over the place, have a great family, have a great girlfriend, things like that. How can I what if that stuff? Because I wouldn't have had that stuff if it wasn't for this.
Exactly. Life's just crazy. Mm-hmm. You know, you just got to live it one day at a time. So there, and I know you are aware of this kid, Mikey Nichols from Monroe. Suffered a very traumatic injury, and it's been said a couple of times that, you know, your advice to him has helped him get through, you know, because he's just going through the early stages of recovery, and your advice and you being there, because you've been there now, mm-hmm. you've experienced this for almost 5 years now. At the end of the day, when it's all said and done, how do you want to be remembered?
I want to be remembered for someone who's never gave up, looked at me as a hero. Looked at me as someone that people could always lean on. You know, I consider myself very strong mentally, physically, everything. You know, I just, you know, I really believe that God put me here to help other people. And, you know, other people's struggles that sometimes that they can't deal with, or they look to me as something like, wow, you got to deal with this, you got to deal with that. But I kind of just like brush it off to the side. It doesn't bother me that much. So, you know, I always say you got to appreciate the things that you do have and don't focus on the things that you don't. If it's something that you want, then you work your butt off to go and get it. And that's what I truly believe in. That's what I try to pass on to other people. You know, you got to take every day as a blessing, you know. Nothing's ever guaranteed. Anything could happen in this world. You just got to be appreciative for everything that's around you. Some people are in worse situations than others, but be happy for what you do have. And Mike, if you listen to this, I got them J's for you.
Once again, the 5th annual A Walk to Believe 5K will be June 7th, High Point Solutions Stadium in Piscataway. Last year raised over $65,000 in one day. We're going to try to beat that, right?
Try to beat that. My personal goal, 100K.
And if you want to see more of Eric LeGrand, Twitter and Instagram, at EricLeGrand52, correct?
At EricLeGrand52, and all my websites are teamlegrand.org, or you can go to www.awalktobelieve.org to sign up for the walk, for the 5K walk and 5K run this year.
This is Joe Vitruba for New Jersey 101.5. Thank you, Eric, so much for joining us.
Thank you for having me.